Hi, I'm Nicole, and welcome to Fun Science Demos. Today, I have another design challenge for your students. So, what's today's challenge? Today's challenge is to make a catapult that will throw one, two, or three cotton balls as far as possible. To begin, first I put my students into groups of three. After they're in their groups, I provide them with these materials, either a paper or a plastic cup, one per group, three cotton balls, three rubber bands, three paper clips, three craft sticks, one plastic spoon, and 1 foot of masking tape. I also tell my students that they are not allowed to use any other materials, or if they break these, they don't get replacements, because we want a fair experiment for all of the groups competing. Each student will then get one worksheet, and one person from each group will come up and gather all of the materials for their group. On the worksheet are the rules that each group has to abide by. So the catapult must be constructed again using only these materials, and no replacement parts will be provided, so they need to work carefully. They can use all of the materials or just some of them. If they don't want to use a craft stick, they don't need to. But again, no additional materials. They can poke holes or make any kind of cuts using the craft sticks or the spoon, but no scissors or anything else. Here are three designs that some of my students have made in class. This one, they used all three craft sticks, and they used rubber bands on the bottom and the top to keep it so that the spoon wouldn't fall off. They also used a craft stick at the bottom here to prop up the spoon and their tape, and it would be launched like that. This group decided to go and put the rubber bands to keep this down and two craft sticks. I noticed when I was walking around that one craft stick wasn't enough and the spoon kept falling, and they wanted it a little bit higher to get it to launch farther. And this one again would be launched just like that. This group used a different way. They wanted the spoon to be propped up, but they didn't use any rubber bands. Instead, they taped two craft sticks where they placed the spoon, and then they placed the third one above it so that the spoon wouldn't fall into the cup. And again, to launch it, just pull. So now that we have our catapults built, let's launch them. So take a cotton ball, put it in, and we have launch. Let's try this one and see how far this one goes. One, two, three. There we go. Wow, the cotton balls didn't go that far. So students used some creativity and problem solving to get them to go even farther. Some of the ideas that they used were, what would happen if I combined all three and put paper clips in to make them weighted? What would happen if I made them a little bit heavier using the masking tape? Let's try it. That one went a little bit higher. How about this one? This one has three cotton balls, two paper clips, and tape holding them all together to make it a little bit bigger and heavier. What would happen with this one? Let's try it. Wow, that one went far. Remember, students didn't make this as their first try. They would go and start a design, and if it didn't work, make changes to the cups. This particular group didn't have the rubber bands at first and just had the sticks, and it wasn't holding the spoon, so they put rubber bands on the bottom, like this. But the top was still falling through, so they added two more rubber bands to the top. Then, when they had just the spoon, it wasn't staying either. So they decided to add a craft stick underneath it and tape it so it was propped up a little bit before they were happy with their design. All of the testing and creating these catapults takes about an hour of class time, an hour of problem solving and working together in groups till they finally have a design that they think they're ready to launch. When all of the groups have a working catapult, the whole class will go outside. When we go outside, we line them up and three tries and we launch. I have them record each trial in centimeters, and then I have them figure out the average that it went. When they're finished, we have a couple of conclusion questions. I like to ask them, what did you change in your design? What worked best? What didn't work? What did you notice that made the cotton ball go farther? I do this activity with my fourth grade class every year. You can do this with any grade level. You can adapt it to younger kids or with older kids. If you would like to try this in your classroom, the worksheet is linked to the video description. Your students will enjoy problem solving, designing, and working together. And best of all, they will discover the joys of science. Thanks for watching. Science is cool.
All right, Catapult Try. Take three, get ready, get set, go!